Won't you stay with me? I never thought I'd see the day.
This tide's really in.
Goodbye. Daddy, please don't go.
So I'm going to hit the kayak out. All right, just launched. I'm not sure. I think my battery, my friggin' lithium battery's dead. Or battery, the battery's dead. So I don't know if I'm gonna have a fish finder today. Well, whatever. Have to make do. Let's see if it turns on. Fuck. I know I charged it all night too. I don't. I must have had it plugged in or. Surge protector was off. God damn it. Alright, well, it's not the first time I fish without a fish finder. Alright, so I'm just gonna just kind of navigate to the little inlets over here, the little channels. And see if we can make it happen. Like I said, we're gonna be flounder fishing today. I have two rods with me, my St. Croix and my new Cashin kayak CRT rod, 7-foot rod. It's pretty warm today, which is good. Damn, I wish my fish finder was working. There's a little turtle in front of me. There's a turtle swimming right next to me here. He just went down. Comes back up. It's more of a slack tide right now, high tide. It's probably about 20 minutes ago, peak. It's not windy, but it's a little sporty out here. Sporty than I thought. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pedal out and then I'm just going to drift back. You let the tide do some of the work at least. Alright, let's see if it makes it happen. Alright, so my first setup is going to be this little new Cashin rod I just bought. I have a little Ivy Garcia reel on it, little 300 series reel, with 20 pound braid on it. I don't have a lot of line on it. I have maybe 150 yards on this, so it's not a lot. Put a little J head on it, piece of gulp, and I put some Manhattan paste on it, some procure. And we'll see if we can do a little jigging first, and then we'll throw out the bucktail if we have no luck. And I don't have a fish finder right now, so I can't tell you how deep the water is, but it's pretty clear. It's not, I don't think it's too deep here. It might be like 6-7 feet here, but it's fluctuating a lot here, and the tide's going to go way out in a little bit, so we'll see. I'm just going to jig a little bit. Like I said, I'm going to let the tide do some of the work. I'm going to pedal up and then drift back with the tide. Let's see if I can tice up the bite. This piece of gulp, chartreuse color. Nothing yet. I also have 30 pound mono leader on it too. I also bought the St. Croix rod here. I have a little bucktail set up on there. I'll probably jig and troll with that a little bit too. I like trolling with them on the kayak. You know, at a slow pace. This is my first time using it. Well, I did use it bass fishing back in February. That's the last time I had this rod out. I kayaked a couple times since. Fished down here once, but on the other side of the Corson's Inlet. We out creekside. Who knows if any fish are here? I know the reports aren't good today, but the weather's better. I think tomorrow, it's first weekend of July, so very light setup. Stripers on bikes like this might be be a challenge. I'm really pissed at myself though that I must not have charged my lithium wilderness battery pack. I thought I did. I plugged it in, but I must not have had the surge protector on that was plugged into it. I don't know. Bite. It's gonna be little, whatever it is. And I'm hitting bottom. Damn it. Oh, a little baby flounder. He's a little guy. He's tiny. That's a bite though, so I'll take it. Started the day. I think it's my third cast. And I have a little flounder. Alright, well, let's get you back in. Measure him anyway. I know obviously he's probably like 7-8 inches. Oh Jesus. Come here, bud. Damn, this might be the slimiest fish I've ever felt, honestly. Oh, so much for that. All right, well, he was little. He was really slimy. My God. Alright, I'm going to have to paddle out of this little sandbar here. Go back out to the middle if I can. That's going to be the challenge here. Alright, well, one little fish on the board. Let's go back out of where I was. Cast. I hate not having my fish finder on. I mean, I can see it's pretty clear today. Water's not dirty at all. Like it normally is, but it's this stuff really fluctuates. Like right now, I'm probably like a foot of water again. Paddle a little bit. Fish on. Another little guy. If I can keep the stay on. This reel. I like the rod, I don't like the reel. Clamshell. Yeah, I might switch up to the St. Croix. Only because it's real. I'm gonna have to upgrade it. That was it. But that wasn't what I had on. I had something biting on it. It was probably like a little sea robin or something. Setup here. Not that I'm abandoning the well, I'll go back to that because that's my favorite. But I'm gonna use this little bucktail. I put a little piece of squid on it. I want to say it's a 2 ounce bucktail, maybe 3 ounce. I have a little piece of like bubblegum swim bait, and I have a little float beads on it for the trail end. And I'm just gonna kind of like just jig this guy for a little bit. I'm just gonna case it just in front of the boat here. St. Croix.